I actually get this question quite a bit. Is it okay to do my Meibomian gland expression at home? This is where someone takes some forceps and squeezes the oil out of their oil glands and their eyelids to help them with their dry eyes. Now, I wanted to go over why doctors actually do this and if it's something that you should be doing at home. Let's focus in. Now, just a quick review. The oil glands in the eyelids, the meibomian glands, play a huge role in dry eye symptoms, dry eye disease. In fact, people that have dry eye disease, 86% of them have a component of meibomian gland dysfunction, poor functioning oil glands. How the oil glands are supposed to work is every time you blink, some oil is secreted out of those oil glands, and then it's spread over the layer of your tears. And that oil becomes the lipid layer of your tears, protecting the tears from evaporating and drying out. And as you can imagine, if that oil is poor functioning, it's not getting spread out, then people tend to have more dry eyes because their tears can evaporate faster. And the list of causes to meibomian gland dysfunction, it's a long list. It can range from Demodex, eyelid mites, eyelid inflammation, blepharitis, rosacea, environmental. If you tend to work on the computer all day long, we have a reduction in blink rate, and that can cause changes to the meibomian glands. Hormonal changes, diet, cosmetics, allergic conjunctivitis. If you have allergies, that can change the function of the oil glands. And the list goes on and on and on. All these changes will affect the function of these oil glands. It can cause them to atrophy. They'll actually shrink down. You can cause them to be capped or clogged by either biofilm, some bacteria, or keratinized or scar tissue will clog the oil glands. And when they get clogged, the oil just gets trapped in there. It becomes stagnant and rancid, and then it'll just stay in there. The oil gland just stops producing new oil and just stops working altogether. And because of this, the meibomian glands have gained a lot of attention in the past with a lot of research, a lot of treatments and protocols, a lot of doctors trying to figure out what's the best way to treat it and awaken those oil glands, clear out the oil glands. And so that's why there's a lot of attention, a lot of people asking how they can best treat their meibomian glands. The mainstream home treatment usually involves warm compresses where you can heat up those oil glands, heat up the oil so they can come out easier. Eyelid massages where you can gently massage the oil glands to express the oil out of those glands. Keeping the eyelids clean. Eyelid hygiene has become a big thing with hypochlorous acid solution, eyelid wipes, different devices that can clean your eyelids and eyelashes better. And the list goes on. Now, a lot of people ask, okay, what about meibomian gland expression, where you actually have a forceps tool and squeeze the eyelids, squeeze that oil out of the oil glands? Is that something that we should do at home? Now, you will be finding more and more doctors doing meibomian gland expression. Usually, it's followed by some type of thermal expression or thermal treatment to those oil glands where they can heat up the oil glands and that oil and then do a meibomian gland manual expression. They'll use a forceps tool like this and actually squeeze the oil glands individually to get that oil out. There's actually a lot of debate surrounded by doing meibomian gland expression in the office by doctors. Are we doing more harm to the oil glands than good? By expressing or pinching too hard, will we be damaging the oil glands? We could possibly damage the opening pore of the oil glands. We could be pushing the oil deeper down in the tissue the opposite way that we want to go. And so there's a lot of questions about that. Are we doing it successfully where it's actually going to help the patient? Are we applying enough heat before we do the expression? Are we doing it too much? Are we doing it too little? There are a lot of questions that doctors have and differing opinions. Like I said, a lot of debate around it. Now, this brings me to the big question. Is this something that you should be doing at home for a treatment for your dry eyes? Because people can get their hands on these meibomian gland expressor forceps. But does that mean that you should be actually squeezing your eyelids at home to get that oil out? And I would definitely caution people on doing this at home. Because of the possible damage that can be done to the oil glands and possibly cause the meibomian gland dysfunction to be worse in the long run, this is something that's likely best done in the doctor's office by the doctor under the microscope so they can actually see if it's being helpful, see if it's something that's actually being productive to those oil glands. And you might find some doctors that just don't want to do Meibomian gland expression at all. There are some doctors that prefer Meibomian gland probing, where they actually take a probe and actually break down that keratinized tissue or that scar tissue if it's been clogged and built up for a long, long time. That could be the way to go to actually get those oil glands working again. Again, any treatment at home where you're trying to help those meibomian glands, especially with eyelid massages where you gently use your finger or a Q-tip, you still want to be careful there that you're doing it properly. And so meibomian gland expression with forceps may be a step too far. I think there's actually going to be a lot more studies and research and treatments that will come out for meibomian gland dysfunction just in the next few years, just because a lot of attention is put on the oil glands just because it is so prevalent. And so hopefully in the next few years, we'll even have better treatments. I'll come out with a new video that can hopefully help with the meibomian glands. But in the meantime, definitely check out my playlist on how to treat meibomian gland dysfunction, blepharitis, to help you with your eyelids and dry eyes right there. I'm Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy. Stay focused.